We've heard some really, really interesting things from lots of people who are doing really cool stuff. I'm going to be talking about some existing research a little bit. This theory that one of the benefits of open access is your work gets out there, it gets read more, it gets cited more. In order for that to be true, two things kind of have to happen. Well, yes, the open access papers need to be read more, the papers that are read more need to be cited more. So, you know, to give you the bullet points up front, yes, they are read more. Not totally sure about the citations. In some cases, yes. In some cases, no. And I'll tell you a little bit about some of that detail. So here's the money slide here. A lot of research has looked at the effect of the differences between the way open access articles and non-open access articles are cited. Many of them have found that you have an increased likelihood to be cited if you pick an open access article at random, kind of looking at it from an epidemiological standpoint. Your relative risk of being cited is higher. That's the actual framework they used. There's another one who did this controlled trial where he went to a publisher that was a closed access publisher, randomly made some of their articles with their permission open access, and then looked at it afterwards, which was kind of artificial, and they came up with results that don't necessarily mean anything. But he did find that those papers were downloaded and read almost twice as much. And this has also been shown. So this is in health. It's also been shown in legal scholarship and in economics. So there's pretty good evidence that, if for no other reason, you should publish your work open access just for the selfish personal reason that it gets your name out there more. You can have more bragging rights. So that said, citations are not the only thing that matter when it comes to looking at your scholarship. You have a much greater impact on the world at large by the research that you do than just on the people who are reading and citing your papers. Ideally, your work is going to have an impact outside of academia, and I think most of you are probably hoping that would be the case. It's not just other people reading it are also in your little field of science. Funding agencies, it happens more of that too. All of the major U.S. funding agencies have public access policies. Private funders are following suit. You need to understand this because they're going to start asking you, and if you tell them, this is how I'm getting broader impact for the grant money I'm asking you to give me, that's getting to be an argument that the funders are really more receptive to listening to. I come from Mendeley. I thought I would take a look at this and see, is there any relationship on our platform between downloads and readers and all this kind of stuff? It turns out that there is a little bit of a relationship, but there's a whole lot of people that are downloading things, or maybe they're not people, maybe they're bots or text mining things or whatever that are not coming up as readers. So there's some interesting things going on there. Curiously enough, if you just look at PLOS and you look at their downloads where they filter out some of the bot counts, you see a better correlation. So sort of supporting that that theory. But broader picture. So we talked a little bit about citations. There's also all of these other things over here, like ratings on F1000, comments on PLOS. PubMed Commons wasn't around when this study was done. And you can see that the activity of each of these things most looks like itself. So citation-like activity correlates. So the darker the square here is, the higher the correlation of each measurement is to the other measurement. Okay, that's what this is showing you. And you can see citations most look like citations. Social activity kind of really only looks like itself, but it kind of looks like some other social activity. And then there's this middle thing with downloads, Mendeley saves, site you like. That kind of looks where they kind of look like themselves a little bit. So this is like these things here, they're calling scholarly sharing. And so it's a citation-like behavior. So all of those things are important for understanding the impact that publishing open access has on your work.